we're giving away a free HD digital copy of Star Wars The Last Jedi. All you have to do is subscribe and leave a comment down below. We're also announcing the winner for the Despicable Me 3 giveaway. Stick around to the end of the video to find out who wins. You can also purchase a copy of this movie in the descriptions down below. This is how the cover looks like. It looks great. The movie is written and directed by Rian Johnson, who also directed Looper. The story takes place right after The Force Awakens. The cast includes Mark Hamill, Carrie Fisher, Adam Driver, Daisy Ridley, John Boyega, Oscar Isaac, and Andy Serkis as Snoke. The Blu-ray is jam-packed with over 5 bonus features and 13 deleted scenes. The bonus features run over 2 hours long. The Blu-ray comes with 2 Blu-ray discs and your free HD digital copy of the movie. By the way, we're giving that away for free. All you have to do is subscribe and leave a comment down below. Don't forget, you can also purchase a copy of this Blu-ray in the links down below. This is how Disc 1 looks like. Play, audio commentary, scene selection, setup. The menu looks really plain. This is how Disc 2 looks like. Bonus features and subtitles. The bonus features are The Director and the Jedi, which is 1 hour and 35 minutes, Balance of the Force, which is 10 minutes, Scene Breakdowns, Andy Serkis Live, One Night Only, Deleted Scenes, which run for 23 minutes, and Info. The Director and the Jedi talks about how Rian Johnson got the director role and his journey from beginning to end. Balance of the Force. It talks about how they wanted to reinvent the Force and not make it look like a superpower. Andy Serkis Live. It's basically showing a scene with Andy Serkis wearing his mocap costume and showing his performance without CGI. Scene breakdowns include Lighting the Spark, creating a space battle, Snoke and Mirrors, and Showdown on Crate. The deleted scenes are Alternate Opening, Page Gun Jams, Luke Has a Moment, Poe, Not So Much of a Sower, It's Kind of Weird That You Recorded That, Caretaker Sizes Up for Grey, Caretaker Village Sequence, Extended Father Chase, Mega Destroyer Incursion, Extended, Rose Bites the Hand That Taunts Her, Phasma Scrolled Like a Whoop Hog, Rose and Finn Go to Where They Belong, Rey and Chewie in the Falcon. Now, I'm going to describe and talk about some scenes I feel like should have been in the film, so this is a spoiler warning. Luke has a moment. That should have been in the film. Rey tells Luke that Han Solo passes away. Luke goes inside his hut. He cries because he's trying to take in that information and one of his closest friends passed away. Poe, not much of a sower. Poe is just talking to Finn, catching up with him on what he missed out while he knocked out. And then the scene leads on to the part where Princess Leia slaps him. It's kind of weird that you recorded that. BB-8 shows Finn a recording of Rey talking to him while he was knocked out, and Finn really liked that recording and told BB-8, hey, that was kind of weird that she recorded that. Caretaker Sizes Up with Rey. I feel like it should have stayed in the film, because the only thing they cut out was basically the caretaker staring down Rey. Mega Destroyer Incursion Extended Scene. When Finn, Rose, and the smuggler guy sneak into Snoke's ship, and it's more longer, and the scene has them entering an elevator, and a stormtrooper recognizes Finn. The person who plays the stormtrooper is actually Tom Hardy, and the people behind him, one of them is played by Prince Henry. Yeah, those are the only scenes I think should have stayed in the film. Now, is Star Wars The Last Jedi worth buying on Blu-ray? The movie was good and bad. I was confused to why some plot points weren't covered in the movie, but I realized that the movie was directed by Rian Johnson, and he disregarded all the notes that J.J. Abrams gave him for the sequel. Rian Johnson just decided to make his own plot for the film. That is the reason why the movie itself had a lot of backlash. And with the bonus features on the disc, you can see how some of the actors were divided with Rian Johnson's decision. But overall, I still enjoyed the movie, and this is definitely worth buying on Blu-ray. Congratulations to the winner down below. Don't forget to message me at this channel to see how you can receive your prize. Don't forget to watch our next video to find out who wins our next giveaway.